Hi, I'm the proud owner of a Mega 65 for 2 weeks now, and I would like to talk a little bit about my first experience with the Mega 65 and what I'm planning to do with it. First, a few words about the Mega 65. It's a new 8-bit computer based on the Commodore 65, which never saw the light of the day. The C65 was designed to be compatible to the C64, while offering a lot more features like more colors, more RAM, more CPU power, and so on. But as the C65 was never completed, only a few prototypes exist, the Mega 65 project had to finish a few things and round a few things off to create this new machine now that is sitting in front of me. I've been following the project since almost its beginning, around 7 or 8 years ago, when it was still called the C65 GS instead of the Mega 65. And back then it wasn't even sure if it would ever become a real computer that you can buy. But now you can see it's sitting in front of me, so the time has come. But the closer the project got to its completion, the more I wondered what I might do with it once it arrives. So I didn't want to take a full dive into assembly programming yet on the Mega 65, because the games I usually make for the C64, they don't require any enhanced features. They are simple enough that they run on a stock C64. So I was wondering if I should code something for the Mega 65 specifically, and I had no idea what I would do on that powerful machine. But at some point, I decided that it might make sense for me to have a basic experience on the Mega 65. What do I mean by that? So when I started coding on the C64 as a kid back in the days, it was in BASIC, of course, and while I had a lot of fun with that, of course the BASIC had two main limitations for me. One of the limitations is that the C64 BASIC has no specific commands for any graphic or sound capabilities of the C64. So all the cool things that you can do with the C64, you cannot access really directly from BASIC. You have to use peek and poke, and basically you have to think already like an assembly programmer just to bring a few sprites on the screen and so on. And that was really annoying. There were some other machines, like the C128 or the Amstrad CPC and so on. They had a much better BASIC with a lot of more commands specific to those graphic and sound capabilities. But the second problem is that the execution speed of the BASIC was also really, really slow. So it was really not suited for any kind of action games or something like that. So you could maybe draw a few nice pictures for your adventure games or draw some mathematical functions or whatever, but it was not possible to create a decent action game with BASIC on the C64. But now the Mega 65 comes in and it addresses both of these problems. So first of all, it has a lot more dedicated commands for graphics, sound, and everything you would like. And second, it's possible to run at 40 megahertz, so it should be fast enough to really code something decent in BASIC. So that's where it becomes great and interesting for me, because over the recent years, I have become a bit nostalgic about BASIC, because there is just something cool about being able to turn on your computer and being able to directly code something in BASIC. That's really cool, and that's something unique for the 8-bit computers. You don't have that anywhere else. It's so cool, and if you remember that, you know what I mean, because there is just something magical about being able to turn on the computer, write a few lines of code, maybe 5 lines, and you have a really cool effect going on or something. You can impress some people who have no idea what you are doing on that machine. It's just fun. Yeah? You cannot do that with any other computer. It's really unique to the 8-bit era of home computers. And now with the Mega 65 and its improved capabilities, you can really create something nice and enjoyable with a few lines of BASIC in no time, and it won't be too complicated, and you will have a lot of helpful BASIC commands available. Take the chardev command, for example. With a single line of BASIC, you can redefine the look of a graphic character or even an ordinary letter, and that was not possible on a C64. So it's just one line and you have a unique piece of graphic that you can use in your game. That's really cool. It's so convenient. So to illustrate how you're doing that, I will draw a small character on a piece of paper. By the way, this is a special notepad that you can get from Dr. Vuru Industries. I will put a link into the description, and this makes it very convenient to draw 8-bit graphics and so on. So I'm drawing this smiley face now. I'm calculating the bit values into hex values, and the great thing about the Mega 65 BASIC is that you can even use hex values directly. That is really an advantage. And then you can add this character to your font. I'm overwriting now the heart character, which is number 83. And I'm overwriting that with the smiley face. And now you can see that I can use the smiley face instead of the heart. And that is really cool. For making things a bit easier and being able to change the characters on the fly directly in the BASIC listing, I even coded a little routine that translates data lines into the hex values, so you don't have to use checkered paper if you don't want to. And if you download this program or use this routine in your own program, then you can even change and design the characters directly in your BASIC listing. Another example is the move sprite command, or move spr. With this command, you can tell a sprite to move to a certain location in a certain speed or at a certain angle and so on. And that is also really helpful because you don't have to move it pixel by pixel. You just tell it where to go. And the interrupt handler, which is running in the background of the BASIC interpreter, will take care of it. So it's really easy to move a sprite across the screen while you're doing other calculations in your BASIC code. And that's also really nice to create something like a simple arcade game like Pac-Man or something like that. For getting the sprite into the RAM, I have also created such a routine that reads the sprite data from data lines. So you can find that in the Balloon 65 program that I have made, and I will also put the link into the description, of course. So now I would like to talk about my first game that I have created in BASIC, and it's called The Wall. Of course, it's not a very unique or special game, so don't expect something over the top. But it's still cool because it has been coded in 2 or 3 hours directly on the Mega 65 in BASIC. And it just shows that you can create something that looks like a game, plays like a game. You can play it with your family or friends. And so it is a complete game. It is simple. It is working, and it was made in BASIC, and it would be much slower and much more inconvenient to code on a C64. So maybe you remember a C64 game called Lazy Jones, which was essentially a collection of mini games, and one of those games was called The Wall. And when I played this as a kid, I always died right away, and I wasn't really able to play the game, because once you die, you have to play a different mini game, so I could not really ever really play the game. So now I decided to port it to the Mega 65, and now I can play it all the time, as long as I want. And I really like the simpleness of the game, or all the other mini games of Lazy Jones, because they are really simple. They have a few elements, and they represent the game objects, and you really know what everything means. So, for example, here's just a few walls and a few plants and so on, and it's so simple, but it looks so cool on an 8-bit computer. So the idea behind the game is that you are located inside a walled garden, and you're controlling a little arrow that is building another wall. And the objective is to create the longest wall possible without ever hitting an obstacle. So it's basically similar to Snake or Tron or something like that, but it looks a bit nicer in my opinion. So in order to code such a game, first you have to draw a level to the screen, which I have done using simple print statements. That way the level is always the same, which makes it better for high score comparison. But of course, with a little bit of more code, you could also transform it to be randomized if you want to. Of course, you can download the code and you can modify it or create your own inspired game. That's not a problem. And you can toy around with it and maybe create a randomizer for the level. Now, the funny thing is that once the program is executed, you can see the modified characters in the listing. So as you can see, you see the little walls and the plants now on the screen. So I decided to use Shift W for the wall character and Shift P for the plant. The wall and the plant have been designed using data lines, as I mentioned earlier. And I also had to design two more arrow characters, because on the Mega 65 keyboard, just like on the C64 keyboard, there are two arrow characters available for left and up, but not for down and right. So I created those as well. And I used Shift R for the right arrow and Shift D for the down arrow. One thing to know about the Mega 65 is that there is an 80 characters mode and a 40 characters mode. 40 character mode is just like on the C64, and it, to me, it feels a bit more old school and more retro, and that's why I also coded the game using this mode, because as you can see now, all the graphics are little squares, and I prefer that for the look of a game. But during coding, it can be very helpful to use the 80 characters mode, because then you have much more space on the screen for your lines. So for example, you can see the level much better in 80 character mode versus 40 character mode. You can switch the modes by pressing the escape key followed by the X key. One thing I really enjoyed during the basic programming exercise was to use the built-in disk drive for saving my progress. In the beginning, I thought I would probably almost never use the drive, because it's obsolete technology and so on. But I always liked the drive because it really looks cool. But now for basic programming, I think it's really perfect to have it, because it's much more convenient than having to handle disk images and so on. Now I just have a disk, a real disk, and I use that for my basic programs, and I slide it in and I save my programs, and it feels much more natural, and it feels really cool to have this. So even though you might use disk images and SD cards for programs from other people and so on, it's still really cool to use the internal disk drive for your own basic programming. Another thing that I really enjoyed was to use the printed manual during coding. So I found almost everything inside this manual. Sadly, the manual is already outdated already, so because it was printed half a year ago, and the development of the firmware and the software of the Mega 65 is still ongoing. So the manual is really sometimes a little bit outdated, but for my game that was not a problem, because almost everything that I needed could be found inside. So that's also really cool, and I'm looking forward to buy another issue of the manual once it's really finished. So I really hope the Mega 65 team will offer a new version of this manual once everything is finished. So now I hope I have inspired you a little bit to do some basic programming on your own. And I really hope you have a lot of fun with your Mega 65. And I have one special announcement for you. So if you would like to see your basic program in a printed magazine, then please consider joining the Magazine Project. This is about to be a printed magazine that contains basic listings made by people from the Mega 65 community for others to type in from the magazine into their Mega 65, just like in the old days. You might be a bit skeptical, but let me show you this. This is a similar project from the C64 scene, and it has already 4 issues, and it was really successful, and people enjoyed typing in those programs from the paper. And now imagine what you can do with the Mega 65 with the improved BASIC, with the improved execution speed, with all those nice commands and features, it will be even more fun to type in those programs. So if you like to join this project, I would be very glad to hear from you, and I will also put the link into the description for that. So that was my video. I hope you had some fun with it, and keep coding.